Hi Zoltan, would you like to introduce yourself to our viewers?
Hi, I'm Zoltan and thanks for the invitation. I'm a software developer, working on front-end, back-end and various technologies in the last 20 plus years.
Thank you, very experienced developer we have here with us today.
I just try.
Can you tell us how long have we known each other?
More than 10 years, 12.
Yeah, and how many projects have we worked on together? Can you remember all of them?
Yeah, I would say around five at least now.
Five at least, yeah. And you were the developer on all of these projects and I was the designer, right?
Yes, yeah, that was a few serious ones.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, can you talk about one of them?
Yeah, I think it was fantastic to working on a business banking project together where we actually built an awesome new business banking software for business customers in New Zealand.
Yes.
So that was one of our last projects, I think, mm-hmm. together.
Can you describe how was the design team on that project? How many designers we had? How many developers we had? Can you recall?
As I remember, we had a separated design team who worked together with the software developer team. The design team, 3-4 people worked on the design system, on the widgets and the various screens. And also, because this project was a kind of a greenfield project, we started from scratch. This is why we had to figure out almost every aspect of the software, started with the login screen and the list of accounts, transferring money, and also the design system of course had to kind of align with the corporate design. Back in that time we worked together in office, so it was easy to mm-hmm. to work on a project with the designers. Wherever after when the pandemic hit, it was easy to and simple to move forward and work remotely mm-hmm. as well with the team, because we had those tools what we actually used to pass over the design concept and the components. So that tool was Figma. Mm-hmm. So we used Figma, and as a software developer, we actually used as a source of truth.
The question that So the question why I invited you here today, because this video's topic is to name or not to name layers in Figma. It's like Shakespeare. To be or not to be. To name or not to name. No? You don't get it?
Yeah, I get it. Yeah.
Okay, so this is funny for me. So should designers... Should designers name their layers in Figma? When you open up a component in Figma, let's say this is like an input field with a label, with error message, warning message, with all of these variants, how much do you care about the named layers in that component?
In the component, I don't think so it actually matter.
Why not?
Because you kind of checking about the gaps, the corner radius,
the distance,
the margin, and the padding, mm-hmm. and all of those parameters. This is what we follow, mm-hmm. and this is what we actually copy. Sometimes it's already there, the CSS there, and you just copy paste it and you update to your own framework. But you don't really, checking that how do you name the label and the box mm-hmm. Of that that component. When we get this kind of source, I think it's important to find what you actually want to build. The best option, of course, you attach to a Jira story. Mm-hmm. So there is a link which is directly leads to the component what you want to build. But in that case, usually you don't really checking how do you name the sublayers in that screen. You just want to find the widget. So if you can link the widget, that's great. How do you kind of layer it? It helps maybe for the designers, but not really for the software developers.
So when you say widget, you're talking about the Figma component.
Figma component. Yeah.
Okay.
What is important, mm-hmm. Finding the screens mm-hmm. in the Figma project, that's important. If the Figma structure follows the expected route what the user would follow, mm-hmm. that's also great. So you want to find it, especially when the project getting, much bigger and you have to go back to a certain part of the screens.
When you got the component in Figma from the designers, let's say this is a new button element with all of the states, and then you need to build this in whatever language you're using or framework you're using. So how do you do that? Do you translate that into HTML, CSS, or are you using some kind of framework language like React or Angular or Ember.js? How does this work? Maybe naming the layers is more important when you translate the component into HTML, CSS, or into
I think in an ideal world, that one thing is the design is created in Figma. After you are creating a component, let's say you use React, so you create a React component. Sometimes React component you compose from subcomponents as well. So when you have a complex form, of course you have a separated input field component. In that case, of course, each of them has a name, because one of the form, let's say a transfer money form, in that case you calling and naming your components based on what it does, so it's easy to find. For long term, because you know the people working on a project, they are changing, so it's good to have easy to find and match those things together. The best option, if you have a storybook, for example, and you have collection of your components, like a component library. In the most ideal world, of course, these names are matching in these three different systems. Those naming are actually, in that case, is important.
So the sub-layers are not important. The components' names should match with the storybook component name and also the React component name.
That would be important, yeah, I think. Yeah,
so,
good.
And what if the designers don't name a component in a right way? Like they say button 1, button 2, button 3.
It's good to have something which is representing, you know, if there is a button which is, you know, approval button or a cancel button or some kind of like role of that button, and this is so you reuse it, just use that name so it's easy to find it, because then if it's a meaningless name, then you cannot find it later. So it's much more clearer. Always think about your future self or the next designer, next developer who's gonna join to the project. That's always the rule of matter. You know, you are designing for your colleagues to maintain this project, to be able to change later or find if you have to debug something. Where else do you use those components? Because you link together those things. In code, in programming, is easy because you can see where to use that component, which are the screens. And when you want to change it, you want to see that it's going to change it everywhere. So I think this is what you can also do in Figma. When you have those components and you reuse in a different pages and you change it in one place, it's going to change in another page. And this consistency should kind of represent it, or should happen in the code as well, in the system, what you actually release.
Can you think of an example in the engineering development community that just kind of creates a similar heated conversation, like naming a Figma layer or not naming Figma layer?
Yeah, always depths or spaces. That's, you know, never ending story for us developers, isn't it? I think it's important to be consistent. So if your team decides, like, okay, this is how we name certain things, talk together and collaborate and stick to that rule. And if you can, in software development, you can use linters, which basically alerts you if it's something out of the agreed convention. It's mainly just the maintainability for long term, and actually it looks good when all the characters, all the titles, all the names looks the same.
Yeah. If we would like to summarize this, what's important? Naming all of the Figma layers is not important for engineers. Naming the components, the main component in Figma that is important or could be important, that name should match with the storybook component and also the
React component name, yes.
The React component name. And you mentioned a really good one that I really love what you said. You are making all of these designs and all of these components for your colleagues, for other designers, for other developers, then they can actually pick it up, they can find these components, and then they can work with it easily. And also you mentioned maintainability of the component, both in Figma and also in the code side. Is there anything else that you want to add?
You summarized it beautifully, and I think that's the most important. Like, you know, think about a future when you have to maintain and upgrade and debug the project what you are working on, because, you know, you want to save time there as well. So this is why if you do it now and build following certain simple rules, then it's going to be much easier later.
I was thinking about why this is like such a hot topic for designers. And I was thinking when I started designing in Fireworks and Photoshop. And do you remember like how important it was in Photoshop to name all of the layers, to find them, because they were building up on each other? You couldn't really select like one of them. You had to find that layer and you had to name it properly to be able to find it later on, and whenever you handed over that PSD file to someone to work with it. So I was just thinking, maybe that's what people are thinking, like we need to work, like designers, we need to work with Figma, like how we work with Photoshop in the past.
In any kind of naming debate, you have to stick to that rule only if, you know, if it makes sense.
Yeah. So how would things change if you are the only one who works on a project? I'm actually thinking, like, me as a designer, if I am the only one, and I know I am the only one who's managing that file, I am much messier in my Figma file, so I don't really care about not even naming the component levels. So because I know that, oh, this is just me, who will ever see that?
You will see that half year later, and you don't know what you actually done in that certain part of the of the project. So you actually helping future self when you are naming properly, and it's a good habit because you get used to it. When you jump in a project where you work with a team, it's gonna be much easier to kind of like following your habit. So this is why, like, it's important when you work alone, you're working on your own project, it's just take it seriously as well.
So my takeaway is I should name my components when I am the only one in that project even. Thank you. Well, that concludes our session. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
I really appreciate your taking the time and coming to the show, the YouTube show. If you would like to see Zoltán again and have another, maybe it could be a series like between engineer and designer, like submit a few topics to us. And are you happy to come along next time?
Yeah, anytime. If you guys need help.
It's a leading question.
Yeah, just.
So he would be very happy to come along again.
Yeah. Yes. I'm around.
Yes, literally, he is around. Thank you for watching. Thank you for your time. If you find value in this video, please hit the like button and share this with your colleagues. And I see you next time. Bye.